First of all, before I do anything else, I want to thank Michelle for giving me the opportunity to make this video. We're talking about the silent B, the B in LGBTQ, bisexuality. Now, people who identify as bisexual are often misunderstood. And hey, I didn't even understand it myself until I was in my mid-20s. I was always told by my dad, you know, don't let anyone come up behind you because once he gets it in there, you'll be gay, just like him. Now, I didn't want to be gay. Being gay was a bad thing. It was a bad thing. And, you know, in high school, I would be sitting in the front of the class, but the teacher would be walking down the row, and he had this habit of putting his hand in the back of his jeans, just inside his belt, while he was lecturing to the class. And he would walk up the row, and I would be just on the in the front, and you know, to hear him, I would have to turn around, but I could never help but be distracted by what a nice ass he had. But I like girls. So, you know, I knew I wasn't gay, but I was somehow different from everyone else, or different from what I thought everyone else was like. It's, you know, you mentioned challenges in the description. Well, my biggest challenge was finding out who I am, figuring out what I am. And I just saw the video a moment ago with Jim saying that I'm one of those who identifies as 50-50. Well, no, not exactly, because it changes. You know, sometimes I identify 80-20, being 80 straight and 20 gay. And sometimes I identify as 60-40. Sometimes it goes the other way, and sometimes it's 40-60. It all depends on the moment and the time, what frame of mind I'm in, but I'm one of these people who's kind of like a sexual camel. I can go a long time without having any experiences and not really feel any ill effects from it. And now that I'm getting even older, I mean, I'm almost 50. The urge isn't as strong as it used to be, although it's nice when it does happen. But what's really important is not, to me, it's not important what other people think, because I am a person. I'm an entire package. And sexuality is only a part of that. There are so many other parts of me that are irrelevant, that don't matter. It doesn't matter. What I mean is, it doesn't matter what my sexuality is because of all those other things. The only people it should make a difference to are those who I sleep with. And right now I'm in a committed monogamous relationship with a woman, yes. And it's fine. There are times I think of, you know, other attractions, whether to other women or towards men. But the main point is, I think that's what sums up bisexuality for me. It's not a question of what I do. It's what I'm attracted to. I can be attracted to men or women. Sometimes more, sometimes less. I've had more experience with women than with men, but I have had some experience with men. And some of them are really wonderful, let me tell you. I can't stress more that everyone is different. And my bisexuality would probably be different from anyone else's. And I remember once I went to a gathering of people in a big city, and a lot of the people there were bisexual, and then I went to visit my parents shortly thereafter, and my folks were asking me what kind of a get-together gathering was this. It was a party, you know, and I mentioned the hostess of this party, and she had a strange nickname. And so I mentioned the nickname. He said, well, that's a strange name to call someone. I said, well, yeah, you know, it's just another bisexual from the big city, just like me. And my dad said straight out, no, you're not. Just like that. Meaning, like, he just wanted to end the conversation right there. And that was the end of it. Okay, fine. You don't want to know? I won't tell you. I don't know if my mother remembers that to this day. She's almost 80. She was there. I don't know if she remembers the incident. It's never been brought up before. My sister, who's a few years younger than me, I'm pretty sure she knows that I identify as bisexual. To her, it makes no difference. I'm still me. And to no one else should it make a difference unless they're sleeping with me. That's the other thing. Would I consider myself in the closet? Perhaps to a lot of people I am. They don't know about the B in my the bisexuality that I identify with. I don't think it's important for them to know that. And no, I'm about as apolitical as you can get, so I'm not going to get political about it and say rights this and rights that and rights that. Everyone should have rights. Everyone, doesn't matter who. There should be no discrimination on basis of sexuality or orientation or anything, or race or creed or color, whatever. I mean, I've been a victim of discrimination. Not sexual discrimination, no, discrimination for my background, for my heritage, based on where I lived. It happens. It shouldn't be. There shouldn't be anything like that. But am I going to get political about being bisexual? No, I don't think so. It's really nobody's business but my own. And of course, those I sleep with. Oh, the sun came out. Yeah. I don't know what else to say on the topic. Just that, you know, I think the most difficult part of bisexuality is figuring out for yourself that you are. After having been misinformed and told the wrong things about it, about everything while growing up, and that you can't be this or you can't be that, or you shouldn't be this or you shouldn't be that. You just are what you are. And when you figure out what that is, that's like coming out. You figure out what you are, that's like coming out. That's when you're authentic. And I think it's most important that we should all be authentic to ourselves, rather than trying to prove anything to anyone else, because most of them don't want to know anyway. It's none of their business. Well, I don't know if I've adequately covered this, talking about being misunderstood. Yeah, I think if anyone's misunderstood, it would be the one who identifies as bisexual. You know, and if people want to misunderstand you, fine. Let them. It's their loss. I don't mind if I'm being misunderstood. That's, you know, if people don't want to educate themselves if people don't want to learn something, it's their loss. Anyways, thanks again for letting me speak here, and hope some of this made sense.